All right, I just want to go over a few key points for sort of wrapping up the grant and the end of the grant proposal process and the submission process, and talk a little bit about the grant review process. And I just want to point out that I think the Karsh chapters at the end of the book are really, really helpful. And also in the appendix, things like the grant checklist is really helpful. And I would strongly recommend looking it over. And there's a number of questions laid out in that that are things like, you know, are all the objectives that I listed in the goals and objectives section measured in the evaluation section? So it's a number of questions that you can use to kind of go through and review your own proposal and kind of look at it and make sure you've gone back and addressed sort of the main key points when you're in the revising process. So what I mentioned early on in the class is that not only have I written and submitted a number of grants, but I've also reviewed a lot of grants and spent weeks in DC at times, basically all day for a whole week, just reviewing grant proposals for a period of time. And then we do what's called paneling, where you get together with three other reviewers and you sit around and you discuss each section of the grant, and you go through the criteria and you kind of talk through it so that you come to a consensus, or so that if you miss something, somebody else, you know, might be able to convince you to go back and relook at things and adjust your scores. And you also work on laying out your comments and your feedback to the people who wrote the grant. And I'll just tell you that one of the reasons that I push things like during the course, like things like using tables for things like timelines for goals and objectives, is because generally it's really, really helpful. You know, grant reviewers have a set of criteria they're using to go through the grant and look for, and it's really, really helpful if that information is really easy to find. And I always am very appreciative when, you know, an agency submits a grant where the tables are very clear, they're easy to read, and the information that I have to make sure has been included is easy to find in the grant and available. And that sort of helps the review process. Another thing I thought I'd mention is, as part of the review process, there are two different ways that I think evaluators look at grants. You have your criteria, and some will go through and evaluate each section in a sense almost individually. They'll look at, okay, the needs section, does it lay out the needs? Does it have citations? Does it have data? Is there a clear target population, target area? All those things laid out clearly in that section. Then they go on to the next section and they rate that section. And overall, that tends to be how grants are reviewed. They are reviewed and evaluated section by section, and you're given points for each section that we've talked about in the process. But what some people will do is reviewers, they'll look more fully at the entire proposal. They'll read the entire proposal, and then they'll kind of go back and evaluate each section. And the benefit of that is for the grant writer is if you included it in a different section, you know, if they can find it anywhere, they will give you credit for it or try to kind of piece it together for you. But I think one of the things savvy grant writers do is that they make sure that in the sections, if something is, they try to include everything in the section as much as possible in case it is evaluated section by section, even if sometimes that means repeating yourself. But then too, they might also indicate that they've included certain things in other sections. So, you know, if you put your activities as one example in your methodology, but not in your goals and objectives table, you can reference your activities in your goals and objectives section by, you know, pointing out that an activity has been provided for each objective in the methodology section. So it's sort of using some common phrases and things like that to guide the grant reviewers. One of the other issues that this week they brought up in the chapter is, you know, what happens if your grant isn't funded, which is common. The grant world is very competitive, and often it takes, you know, I've submitted a lot of proposals that ended up not getting funded. And hopefully you get good feedback. Your grant reviewers will write and leave you feedback. They try to make it all constructive and helpful, what specifically you could include to better that section. And it's really helpful to look at that feedback and then try to work on your grant. And often grant programs are, they'll come in cycles, maybe annually or every 3 years, sometimes every other year. And what you can do is revise and, look at the areas where your proposal is lacking, fix it, and then resubmit it during the next cycle. So that's really helpful, I think, and it helps you get better. And the other thing I would just say is really the grant world is where you have to learn to deal with rejection and uncertainty and work through it. But I really do think it is worth it long term. Both, even if you are in a profession that doesn't necessarily require grant writing, you can still create other opportunities and jobs and things that you're passionate about. So, later in your career, if there's something else you want to work on or something to give you to kind of bring back enthusiasm into your profession, grants are a great way to create extra projects and, things that are related, obviously, to your profession, but things that can give you something a little bit different or unique to work on. It can be great opportunities to hire people if you get into writing larger federal grants at some point. And then too, they can be very beneficial. You can help write grants on behalf of agencies or nonprofits that you work with or that you're interested in. And that can be a great thing to help your community and things like that. And then too, if as a sort of professional outlet, if you get good enough at grant writing, I mean, I think most universities in the country would give office space to someone and be prone to hiring someone who's really good at grant writing because they know because of the return indirect that they are, that person is going to bring money into the university, that it is beneficial for both parties in terms of getting them the organizational support if they are bringing in grants, because the grants bring in revenue, prestige, they help with rankings, all that kind of thing. And I know a lot of universities have people on staff that primarily their primary job is basically just managing and running grant projects. They're often called around the country soft money shops, but soft money shops are just large organizations that have developed at universities that bring in a lot of external funding. And you do get good at it. It is something too, grant writing, that you build momentum with. So a lot of the charts, the graphs, the organizational structures, those are things that you develop. And then when you have a good structure for them, you can sort of tweak them or move them around. But once you really know how to do them, once you've developed budget templates, things like that, you have them and you can just kind of tweak them and work on them. And it gets a lot easier. The other thing you can do over time is build up professional connections with people and have grant writing teams. And that makes things a lot easier. And I would just end by again reiterating that in the book there's a lot of good information and good advice. There's things like the funders roundtable, which is some sections in the book where the author talked to grant reviewers and kind of got some of their pet peeves and things that bother them. One of the main things I think that came through from that section from me rereading it the other day was that was something I pointed out elsewhere in the class, that grant funding agencies look at your proposal as an indication of how you're going to manage their money and the project, which are both incredibly important for the foundation or for whatever agency it is you're submitting the proposal to. So everything like making sure you have the right font, the right spacing, all those things are essential. And I can tell you, from my time with federal agencies, I never read a grant that didn't have the right font, the right spacing, the right margins, because all of those were already deleted before they even got to me. The department, the federal agency would go through, they would check them, and they would just get rid of any proposal that didn't have the right number of pages per section, the right font, the right spacing, all of those things. need to be exact, and that is something that granting agencies are just really particular about. And it's, you have to really read the guidelines, and kind of go back over them and use those if you're a good grant writer. But again, you do build momentum up. The book is a good resource. Another chapter that's included that I didn't have you read is on site visits. And that's basically something that happens after the grant gets funded. But for any of you who end up working on projects that are funded by grants, or in positions that are grant funded, or if you do get your grant funded, it's really helpful to read that, that chapter. So the book could be something, if you have the option of selling it or keeping it, it might be a good resource down the road. Because of the appendix and all the checklists and different things that are in it, I think it hopefully will be something you find valuable and helpful. So I hope this is helpful. I'd be happy to, to do some more kind of general videos or thoughts on different things. If you'd like, just please email me a question or something to talk about. I'd be happy to do that. And if you'd like me to look over your proposal, I'm always happy to read it and give whatever feedback I have before you submit the actual grant. So hope this is helpful, and I'll be in touch.